Welcome. We are so glad that you are here. I'm John Passberg. This is Kettle Moran Lutheran High School, and I'm the Fine Arts Coordinator here. The choir that's behind me here is our traveling choir. And I'm not going to talk too much about this first song, and then while we transition from song to song, I'll clue you into about some of the things that we're doing. The first song that we are singing, though, is Wana Baraka. And Wana Baraka is sung in Swahili, and I know that the lights will go darker, and it'll be hard to see what the words are, and so I just wanted to share that with you so that you know what these kids are singing for this first opening piece. The words are, they have blessings, those who pray. Jesus himself says so. Hallelujah. They have peace, they have joy, they have well-being. Please enjoy.
Wana Baraka, Wale Ampao.
I did it. While we're transitioning and getting one choir from one group to the next, and we'll let the contrary choir get up here, I wanted to talk a little bit about some things that have happened and some things that have changed. The big, wonderful change for us here in the music department is seeing this shell that encloses in the ceiling here and keeps the sound from going up into the fly area of the drama stage. And it has made a huge difference for rehearsing and being out here with the kids and trying to make things happen. And this is our opportunity, one, to debut that stage. And there are some little tweaks that are still coming, like the lights in the middle of the stage here that are all nicely colored. Actually are supposed to be white lights, but they're 20 weeks back ordered right now. And so they gave us some lights to be able to put in there so that we can use them. So there will be changes that will be forthcoming, but this has been a real, real treat for us to be able to now come in here and hear each other, especially when we're in the auditorium and working. And I just want to say thank you to all the people that were involved. This was a big undertaking, a big project. And I know the marketing group was involved, the last year's auction was involved, and money has been set aside to make this happen. And I just want to have you join me in saying thank you for giving us this wonderful blessing. The choirs today, especially the traveling choir, when they come back up, we're going to be focusing mostly on music that's from our KMO Sundays. Doesn't mean that this is necessarily a sacred concert, and this group is going to be doing some songs that are both sacred and secular. This is our contrary choir, and they've been working just really extremely hard, and it's been a really, really enjoyable group to work with. And so they'll be presenting three songs, and then they'll bring up the traveling choir, and we'll get to do three more. Then we're going to have a piece by the Echoes, and then after that there will be a free will offering, and the baskets will come forward and they'll get passed. We thank you for supporting us. That money goes into the general budget, which is supporting us, and I just wanted to give you a heads up that that's coming, just so that it's not a surprise a little bit later. Then I also wanted to take just a second, I don't have all the kids up here, but we received word just a couple of days ago that we've got five students from this group that were nominated and made it into the All-State Choir, which will be performing in Appleton in January. And Katya Bledel, who's up here, and then there's four more kids from the traveling choir, Emma Christofferson, DJ Gruber, Tristan Mokentine, and Ethan Hader, that all made All-State. Please say congratulations. We're going to start with the contrary choir, and we're going to start with the Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch. of prejudice and hate towards other people, but it is also a reminder that hope held firm will eventually reign victorious over the greatest of odds. These words were inscribed on the walls of a cellar in Cologne, Germany, where the Jews were hiding from the Nazis during World War II. Hope was all they had to hold on to. Hope was their only bridge to a brighter tomorrow.
It's a good problem to have when we've got so many seats filled that it messed up our seating for all these kids and all the things that we practiced all this week. So they're kind of looking at me like, okay, now what are we doing? Because we had a plan. And when you get an audience like this, what a wonderful problem. So this is a great issue for us to have, and then we'll see how they get to figure all this out. Twilight Choir is again getting ready for our KML Sundays, and our first KML Sunday is this next week at Redeemer in Cedarburg. They have one service at 10 o'clock, and so we are looking forward to getting that season started. We usually perform eight to nine songs throughout the service and making that happen, and we've been working hard to try to get a whole bunch of music ready to go for that. And putting together a service, it's important to me and it's important to the choir that we don't just come and perform the entire time, but that we also get a chance to be able to interact and share in singing praises to God in a church service. And so we try to have the congregation join in three, four, sometimes even five times throughout the service, like a typical Sunday would be with hymns. And so our second song from this set, we'll have the lights turn on for the third stanza, and I'm just giving you a heads up that it's all of a sudden pretty quick, because there's only like four measures and the lights will come up and then you get to join in. It is a piece from our new hymnal, but one that might not be as familiar to everybody, and so wanted to introduce that to this group as we go out. But we start first with Child of God, not Child of God, Train Up a Child.
Train up my child.
as we transition the stage, we're going to pull the risers off real quick and put some boxes on. And this is the first opportunity that the Echoes gets to perform. And the Echoes is our show choir and our jazz choir and our chapel choir. And they've been performing for chapels, but they haven't done anything with choreography yet. And so this is our first opportunity to do that. So we're going to do a quick changeover and make that happen. As the risers start to go off and as the panel and things get moved, I will help them in just a couple of minutes. One of the events that Echoes is getting ready for is the National Choral Festival, and this year it's regional choral festivals. There's one at WLHS at Wisconsin Lutheran High School here in Milwaukee. But we are actually going to travel and go to Bethany Lutheran College in Mankato, Minnesota. And part of that is because the next 3 years, all of the festivals are real close. And so we decided we could do one where we could get out on the road and start to travel. And when the kids get an opportunity to spend some time on the bus, they get a little bit closer. And we're going to be traveling with Lakeside. And so they get to know those kids pretty well also. The festival is the 4th through the 6th. And if you happen to be going to Minnesota or want to go to Minnesota and watch this, it's free concerts. There's a concert on Friday night, the 4th, and it's a Pops concert. And then the rest of the week, they spend the weekend, they spend the whole days rehearsing together as mass choirs and putting together a Sunday afternoon sacred concert that will start at 2:30 on November 6th. So again, we'd certainly love to see you there. If you can't make that, it will be live streamed. And all the information about all of that festival is located on wellsfineart.org. Really encourage you to go and look at wellsfineart.org and find the information, and the live streams will all be there for that so that you can watch it from home if you can't make it to Minnesota. As they are transitioning and getting things ready, I'm going to assist, and then we're going to jump right into it. Their song that they choreographed is called Run, and we really hope that you enjoy it. Thank you. short intermission while we bring out the band equipment and get chairs and percussion and everything set up for that. It's also going to be a chance for the offering to happen, and so please let the baskets come up before you decide that you need to get a drink of water or get to the bathroom if you need to. Baskets should be coming forward very, very quickly here, and then it should take about 5-6 minutes and we'll be ready to go.
Thank you. good afternoon. My name is Angela Hohenstein. I'm the director of bands here at Kettle Moran Lutheran High School. The group in front of you is the concert band. This group is made up of our freshmen and sophomores. We've been working hard to prepare our concert for you this evening, or afternoon, whatever it is. We will start off with a piece entitled Rhythm of the Spheres. It definitely is a favorite of the band's, and then we will move directly from that into a piece called The Voyagers. And that one is very cool because it was written by a world-renowned composer who was born nowhere else than West Dallas, Wisconsin. So it's a little bit special. Please enjoy our concert.
Thank you.
before the last concert band piece, we're going to kick Quinn Symphony out so they can go get warmed up and ready to go. The final piece is kind of special because this year's juniors and seniors, some of them got the chance to play this a couple years ago, but we never got to perform it. So this group is finishing their dream and playing this piece in concert for the first time. So this next piece is called Reverberations. It's by Brian Balmages. It's really cool. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks again for being here today to support these young musicians.
Thank you.
Wind Symphony. This is made up of primarily juniors and seniors with a sprinkle of sophomores and freshmen in here who auditioned. We are playing three pieces for you this afternoon as well. The first one is called Cafe 512. It's a tango, it's lots of fun, and features some soloists that you'll hear throughout. And right after that, we'll change the world for something completely different and play Perthshire Majesty, a very beautiful piece featuring a soprano sax soloist. I hope you enjoy the Wind Symphony and the final performance group of this afternoon's concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
right, and just like that, we find ourselves at the end of the concert. What do you guys think of the new acoustical shell, by the way? Pretty awesome. I'm kind of jealous you all get to be up there listening. But anyway, our final piece before that, I just want to remind you about our upcoming things. We have the winter band concert happening on December 4th that will feature all the bands from grade school up through high school. And then the Christmas choral concert is on December 17th. December 4th, again, is that winter band concert. So mark your calendars for the 4th and the 17th of December, so we can hope to see you back here to see and hear some great music. Our final piece by the Wind Symphony is called Undertow. It's energetic, it's exciting, it's loud, so be prepared down here. It's a great way to end the concert. We hope that you enjoyed your afternoon with us, and we look forward to seeing you at all the rest of the amazing events we have coming up this year. Thank you. everybody. Have a great evening, and we'll see you next time.